death. The inevitable force that catches up with us no matter how hard we try to outrun it. For Neil and Angie Jobson, the most painful face of death, that of their only child, has caught up with them. In the midst of their grief, little does this couple suspect that the encounter they're about to have is with the ultimate source of death, as well as the ultimate source of life.
How are you holding up?
Not so good. Just when I thought I couldn't cry anymore.
Did you go see the doctor?
Yeah. Yesterday, before I left, I told him that I hadn't slept in 4 days. I just wanted a prescription for sleeping meds.
He wouldn't give you one?
He thinks I'm anemic.
Well. You haven't eaten in 4 days.
I ran blood tests and everything.
Honey, he's looking out for you.
I know. I know, but still.
This is all so unreal. All this is unbelievable.
Mr. and Mrs. Jobson, thank you for waiting. My name is Victor. First of all, may I say how sorry I am for your loss.
Thank you, Victor.
And I just want you to know that I'm here to help you with anything.
Thank you, but I don't think there's anything you could do to help either one of us right now.
Honey, we knew this was coming. There was never going to be a different outcome.
It doesn't make it any easier.
Angie.
If it's any consolation, Savannah's at peace now. She'll never be sick again. She'll never cry again.
She was only six.
Angie.
That's not how it's supposed to be. Parents are not supposed to bury their children.
I don't know why this happened. Nobody does. Maybe God knows.
Yeah, God. What kind of God lets a six-year-old girl die from leukemia?
Angie, she had cancer. It's a fact of life.
Please, don't despair. Savannah's passing was no one's fault.
How can you be so sure? Maybe if you had stopped smoking years ago, like I asked you to.
Oh, no, it's my fault. We all know that cancer runs in your family.
Not leukemia.
What's the difference?
Neil, I don't want to argue.
Then stop arguing.
Please. I know this is hard, but unfortunately, a lot of decisions have to be made.
I do apologize.
First of all, is it your preference for an open or a closed casket?
Closed.
Open.
We decided it would be a closed casket.
I've changed my mind.
I want people to remember Savannah alive.
You want to remember Savannah alive. I want people to know what I had to go through.
Angie, it's not about you.
Oh, really?
You know, you're sounding a lot like your mother. The same woman who needs to be the bride at every wedding and the widow at every funeral.
Leave my mother out of this.
Oh, I wish I could.
She's flying in tonight, all the way from Long Island.
And she'll never stop reminding us of that fact.
Well, she is Savannah's grandmother. Don't you think she's heartbroken about this as well?
Victor, I don't know what to think about her mother. I'm just happy she lives on the other coast.
The casket's going to be open.
The casket will be closed.
And, what about the final disposition of...
I'm sorry?
Were you thinking of a burial or cremation?
Well, we actually hadn't thought about that.
I can't bear the thought of Savannah being, you know.
We should think about that.
Very well. Tell me, Are the two of you people of faith?
Why do you ask?
Well, I need to know whether to make arrangements for a clergyman.
No. No, we're not religious.
Well, we both agree on that.
Understood. Sounds like I need to leave the two of you alone for a bit. Please take all the time you need. I'll be right up the hall if you have any questions.
Thank you so much, Victor.
Now what?
Thank you, sir. Nora, thank you so much for coming.
Of course. If there's anything you guys need.
You've done enough already.
I hope you don't mind.
Mind?
I mean, I know you and Angie aren't really religious, but I thought it might be nice to have a clergyman stop by. I mean, it is okay, isn't it? Besides, he's a friend of a friend, so.
I thought neither of you were people of faith.
That is true.
I would have been happy to recommend a respected clergyman.
But they're all the same, aren't they? Well, it's fine. Everyone has already left. Most of the people have already paid their respects. Thank you, Nora.
Sure thing. I hope I didn't step on anybody's toes.
Are you okay?
If I hear one more person say that God must have needed another angel in heaven, I know I will throw up.
Honey, people don't know what to say, so they feel obliged to say something.
I know. I know, it's just... Do we know that guy?
I would say he's a preacher.
When did we decide on a preacher?
It was Nora's idea. She was just trying to help.
It's a little too late.
Surprised to see me here?
I'm never surprised to see you.
Well, I was, of course, invited.
You would not be here if I had not allowed it.
If you'll excuse me.
Are you the Jobsons?
Yes, I'm Neil. And this is my wife, Angie.
Nice to meet you, young man. Sorry about the circumstances.
Thank you.
Mrs. Jobson, what can I say? God must have needed another angel in heaven. It's hard to explain these things, you know. But we don't run the universe, do we? Be a lot different if we did.
You're Reverend...
Cadwallader. Reverend Cadwallader.
Is your parish nearby?
My...
Your church?
Oh, yes. You might say I have disciples all over. Now, don't the two of you worry. You both look young and strong, and I'm sure you'll have another baby in no time.
If you'll excuse me, I don't feel well all of a sudden.
Is it something I said?
Well, you see, Reverend, my wife, we can't have any more children.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Well, you couldn't have possibly have known.
Are you sure about that? You know, they've got all this stuff nowadays.
We've tried everything. That ship has sailed.
That's such a pity.
Nora. I know. I owe you a million apologies.
What were you thinking?
I just thought it might be consoling.
Him?
He was recommended by a friend of a friend of a friend. I never met him before.
Couldn't you have just asked us?
I'm sorry, I was only trying to help.
Just get him to leave.
Well, I can't.
Never mind, I'll take care of it.
Sorry, Reverend, I think I misunderstood you. Exactly what are you trying to say?
Well, you know what the good book says. Happy is the man whom God corrected, despiseth not the chastening of the Almighty.
You're suggesting we did something to deserve Savannah's death?
Well, it just seems to me that a righteous person rarely meets with disaster.
I can't believe I'm hearing this. You know, you're the reason why Angie and I don't go to church.
What's going on here?
This preacher man is suggesting that we did something that caused Savannah to die.
That's so insensitive. How could you possibly say something like that?
I'm just quoting scriptures, Mrs. Jobson. Whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap.
Okay, look, I may not be a fully paid-up Christian, but I went to Sunday school as a kid. They certainly never taught us anything like that.
Was it a nice church?
Yes, it was a very warm and loving congregation.
Then why did you stop going?
It's none of your concern.
A foolish woman is noisy. She is ignorant and knows no shame.
I beg your pardon?
The good book, ma'am. Proverbs 9:13.
I will not have you speak to my wife like this, especially now.
And the good book has plenty of advice for you too, young man.
Oh, really?
Why wilt thou, my son, be ravished with a strange woman and embrace the bosom of a stranger? For the ways of man are before the eyes of the Lord.
Who is he referring to?
Honey, I have no idea.
Is there something you're not telling?
Honey, we don't know this man. He's delusional.
He's referring to somebody's bosom.
The Lord will not be mocked.
You shut up.
No, I will not calm down. I flew all the way here from Long Island, and I won't be ordered around by an usher.
Whatever she says, just go along with it.
If I can be any help.
If you get near that woman.
Where is my granddaughter? Where is Savannah?
It looks like your mom had a few.
Neil, don't argue with her. Please. I'm so glad you could be here. How are you holding up?
How should I be holding up? Last week I had a granddaughter. Now I don't have any.
Please, this hasn't been easy for any of us.
What is this? Whose idea of a closed casket?
Mrs. Tiemann, we thought it would be best if we remembered Savannah the way she was.
So this was your idea. I might have known. I rarely saw her in life. And now I can't see her at all?
I know you live far away, but you are always, always welcome at our house.
A fine lot of good it does me now.
Looks like we're gonna have ourselves a perfect storm.
Now, if you had listened to me and brought that child to my hospital with my doctors, she would probably still be alive.
Mom, please.
This is all your fault.
Yep, perfect storm, all right.
I cursed the day you married my daughter. You took her out of my home. Out of my life just so you can make her miserable.
You know, you could have avoided all this had the little girl lived.
There's a reason for everything. I'll use even this to glorify my father.
Mrs. Tiemann, please stop being so dramatic.
You want drama? I will show you drama.
Mrs. Tiemann, please don't. Mrs. Tiemann.
I want to see my granddaughter.
Can I be of some comfort now?
I want to see my granddaughter.
Ma'am, I'm sorry. That's just not possible.
Don't tell me what's possible.
Ma'am, your granddaughter was very sick for a very long time. I think your son-in-law and your daughter made a very wise decision.
You're taking their side as well.
Ma'am, people are grieving.
Please forgive me. I'm a little emotional at the moment. If you'll excuse me.
Why don't the two of you come with me? We could just sit for a few moments.
Thank you, Victor.
Thanks. Don't worry about a thing. I'll take care of everything while you're gone.
You have only as much authority as I've given you. And no more.
Victor, please accept my sincerest apologies for my mother's behavior.
There's nothing to apologize for. Everyone responds differently to grief.
This has been such a trying day for both of us. And that crazy preacher outside.
Yeah. I've dealt with him before.
You have? Then you know he's crazy.
No, he's cunning. That's the only thing I'll give him credit for, but we'll be rid of him soon enough.
Not soon enough, if you ask me.
Angie, this isn't about him, or your mother, or if I may, even Savannah. This is about something more than you can imagine.
I beg your pardon, ma'am. I'm Cadwallader, Reverend Cadwallader.
Oh, hello. I suppose you're on their side as well.
I'm sorry, ma'am.
I mean, you approve of everything they've done here.
Oh, no, not at all. In fact, I'm on your side in this.
Oh, really?
Well, you know how young people are. Right or wrong, they go their own way.
Isn't that the truth? You know, I do believe you are the most sensible person I've ever met in this godforsaken city.
Oh, you flatter me.
Don't get me wrong. I'm not terribly religious, but I do like the way you talk.
Well, let's find a place to sit and we can talk a little more.
Okay. I would like that very much.
So how was your flight out here?
Have no fear, Mr. and Mrs. Jobs. Savannah did not die because of anyone's sin.
Then why didn't God intervene?
Did you ask him to?
If I had, would it have made any difference?
Angie, you will never in this life know the answer to that question. Behold, I am the Lord, the God of all flesh. Is anything too hard for me?
But that's the thing about the Bible, right? You can make it say pretty much anything you want.
Angie, I too know what it means to lose a loved one.
A child?
Many. I did everything in my power to save them. To the point of surrendering my life.
But you're alive.
I've conquered death. Death has no power over me. And that's the good news for you, Neil and Angie. If you are willing to believe it.
You may be surprised, Reverend. I was quite the holy roller in my day.
I would love to hear your testimony.
Back then, it all seemed so illogical. I mean, here I am, God. Talk to me.
And?
Nothing.
I see.
I mean, even if he did talk to me, he'd have a lot of explaining to do.
Would you like to know a little secret? I never could understand why human beings were so important to God. He'd be better off paying attention to the birds or insects even.
Maybe he is paying attention to them. He certainly isn't listening to me.
Wait a minute. Wait 1 minute. Who exactly do you think you are?
Who do you say I am?
No. This is impossible.
After all we've been through, I'm willing to believe anything.
No, honey. We are surrounded by crazy people.
Either I am who I say I am, or I'm the biggest liar who ever lived.
Yeah, so I get it. You're Jesus Christ, and that man out there is the devil.
He is the devil.
I was afraid you were going to say that.
Well, this is simple enough to prove. If you're Jesus Christ, why don't you go out there and bring my daughter back to life? You've done it once before. Lots of times, if I recall.
Yeah, your friend Lazarus, right? He was dead for what, 1 week?
4 days, to be precise.
That is, if he was really dead.
He was dead. I was there. I wept.
So then, you could do this. If you wanted.
With God, all things are possible. But the Creator does not take orders from the creation.
Good answer. But you really could if you wanted.
It is an unfaithful and rebellious generation that asks for a sign.
Victor? I'm not asking for a sign. I'm asking for my daughter back.
For a minute there, I thought I left it on the plane. Care for a shot?
Oh, no, thank you. I'm not allowed to drink.
Religious reasons?
Something like that.
You're probably better off. Although, how you do your job without alcohol is beyond me. Empty. My figures.
Well, Reverend, looks like we cleared the place out.
That we did.
Can I be perfectly honest with you?
Oh, you can tell me anything, my child.
Well, I said I used to be a holy roller. Well, I didn't believe in any of it. I mean, not one word.
I see.
I sang the songs, I praised the Lord, but what did it get me? Breast cancer, bankruptcy, and 3 lousy marriages. I mean, when I married the 3rd time, I didn't even bother with the church. What was the point?
And now this? I mean, if God really loves people,
he sure has a funny way of showing it. There, I said it. And I know you disagree.
Oh, let's not jump to conclusions, Mrs. Tiedemann.
Oh, don't try to convert me, Reverend. It's a little too late for that. If you believe in God and he brings you comfort, then I am happy for you.
Actually, it terrifies me, but we won't go into that.
Well, I realize you can't have everything you want.
Don't I know that?
But just for once, can I have something? I mean, is that too much to ask?
You know, Mrs. Tiedemann, I have an interesting proposition for you.
Reverend, don't waste your time. There is no converting me.
Oh, there's no conversion necessary. We're both on the same side already.
All right. Exactly what do you have in mind?
Well, what if we make a deal?
Neil, tell me, where were you when I created the universe? Did you decide how vast it would be? Have you ever commanded the sun to rise? Are you responsible for the rain and the snow? Have you ever visited the Pleiades? Do you even know where they are? You have challenged me, Neil. Will you give up now? Or will you answer me?
No one can answer those questions. No one.
Then why are you trying to make me look unjust? Isn't it obvious that I can do whatever I want? But I did not come down from heaven to do my own will, but the will of him who sent me. And this is the will of him who sent me, that I shall lose none of those that he has given me, but raise them up at the last day.
Including Savannah?
including Savannah.
Mordecai, I don't know why I ever gave up on you.
Honey, you don't really think...
It doesn't matter if you believe it's him or not. Everything he's saying is the truth. I spoke of things that I didn't understand. And for that, I am so sorry. Lord, your will be done.
Honey, you don't think that I'm buying this?
That's your choice to make, Neil. Right now, I have to tend to something. If you'll excuse me.
You stay away from me, you filthy man. How dare you?
Mrs. Tiemann, I think you misunderstood me.
You couldn't be more clear, or disgusting for that matter. You some kind of preacher? You act more like a demon.
That's because he is a demon. The prince of demons, to be exact.
Thank you for that clarification.
You have no idea what this awful man suggested.
I know exactly what he suggested. He does it all the time.
Then why isn't he locked up?
He will be one day.
Mom. Mom, are you all right?
I am now. Should we call the police?
No, there's no need.
But he might attack again.
He will attack again.
Did he attack you?
Well, he tried.
He tried to attack all three of you. He nearly succeeded.
You pervert. At my daughter's funeral? And you had the audacity to walk in with a Bible.
It's not a Bible, it only looks like one.
Who needs a Bible anyway? It certainly doesn't have a happy ending.
Not for you, it doesn't.
Is he really a demon?
Uh-huh.
Then he must be...
Uh-huh.
Do you think I'm the bad guy? 6 years old. Her whole life in front of her. Now what? You think I'm responsible for this?
Actually, he is responsible. He's the one who brought sin and death into the world. If it hadn't been for him, no one would have had to die, not even me.
Oh, here we go again. I am the good shepherd. I lay down my life. I have the authority to take it up again. Blah, blah, blah.
But can you do that?
Don't think I'm finished with you, mister. We'll meet again.
Yeah. Next time I'll have help. Pray, Jesus?
Don't say that name.
Be gone, Satan. The Lord God commands it.
For the first time in my life, I feel incredibly stupid.
Join the club.
Neil and Angie, I understand the depth of your grief. But I promise you, where Savannah is now, she wouldn't want to leave for 5 seconds. Nor would you want her to.
Could you tell her that we said that?
That we love her.
All of us. And to think I was dealing with the devil himself.
You had no idea. Neither did Nora. Isn't that right, Nora?
Nora, only meant to help. I really mean it. Believe me, if I had known.
But you didn't know. None of us knew.
That's it.
What?
I'm changing my life. The woman I was, I am no more.
That makes two of us. As soon as I leave here, I'm going straight to the store to buy a Bible.
No need. You can have this one.
But it's blank.
I'm gonna read this from cover to cover.
You know, Victor, may I call you Lord? I feel a bit presumptuous asking you this after all the stupid things I said, but can I ask you if I could, we could, have another child?
Yes, you can ask. Nothing is impossible.
But the doctors, they said that we couldn't.
Oh, doctors don't know everything. If I were you, I would consider moving out here.
I'm not sure I'm even going to leave.
My peace, I leave with you. Don't let your heart be troubled. Don't be afraid. Don't lose heart. I am with you always. Always.
It's me. I'm sorry. It's the doctor's office.
Maybe he came through with a prescription.
Which I probably don't need now. Hello?
Mrs. Tiemann. Mom. I just want to say that...
No. Don't say it. You don't have to. I'm the one that should be apologizing. Of course, I never meant all those terrible things I said about you before.
I know.
And all the terrible things I said about you the past 10 years.
I got it.
And I'm sorry for bringing you-know-who. That'll be the last time, I promise you.
Well, if he didn't come, then maybe you-know-who wouldn't have shown up.
Did it really happen, or was I just plastered?
Yes.
Which?
Both, but we'll forget about the one.
And we'll never forget about the other.
From now on, it's only black coffee for me.
And from now on, no more cigarettes for me.
Right, like you're gonna stop smoking?
Like you're only gonna drink black coffee?
Just watch me.
Okay, you're on. Hey, honey. Is everything okay? Did he give you the prescription? What did the doctor say?
Told me that I'm pregnant.
Sweetheart.
I know.
I love you so much.
Life. The inevitable force that defeats and overcomes its opposite. If only we will embrace it, and the one who created it. For Neil and Angie Jobson, that encounter with life has come on the day that they least expected it.
Something happened on the